Hi, today I've got multiple things to show you, not just one specific topic. There are tons of new updates and changes within the project that I've been recording for months, so let's get started. First of all, the user interface. Here's the first version. There were too many resources displayed at the bottom bar. I had to move some of them to other areas where it made more sense. This side viewport was too unnecessarily large and barely displayed any vital info. So I made it significantly smaller and changed the design to fit the rest. Displayed here is your gold, the happiness factor, the population count and limit, plus the timer for the next incoming assault. Also, now there is a bar at the top of the screen, which displays your current active research and how far it has progressed. The culture points were also relocated to this spot. I was almost done, but still wasn't super happy about that corner. The info there just isn't highlighted enough and just looks like a random number. So I changed it up a little and turned them into proper UI elements. Now the importance of these parameters is visually clear to the player. Here's a quick comparison. Before. After. Much better, right? Let me know how you like the changes in the comments. Alright, let's get over to the other updates. The market. That's an own viewport for itself. It is not accessed via building like in most RTS games, but has its own little button in this corner. Here you can sell and purchase all types of resources. Material, food, weapons, and so on. The problem I had with this user interface is that it doesn't clearly communicate which amount of products are being transferred and how much each click is costing you. So I updated it to this. Now everything is perfectly displayed. How much gold you lose and how much materials you get. No confusion should occur here. By the way, some of these icons and resources are just temporary. I'll explain the full economic system and all resources some other time. The market itself will be a very essential feature for the economy of Kratoria. Here's an example. Let's say this map does not offer any iron ore. Technically, you're not able to produce any swords or heavy armor. But your faction may rely on it. Your tactic would then be to focus your production on something else, like stone or food. Then you'd constantly sell that resource to earn the money for you to purchase the weapons you want. Makes sense, right? This way you can make the best out of each difficult situation as long as the gold is flowing. Just like in real life. So that's it for the update video today. I'm currently still working on the wall system. I hope I'll manage to get it running properly and showcase it to you soon. It's not looking that good right now. Okay, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.